these finitive respective places. Today, I would like to give you 10th Standard English, Unit 6, Part B, Poem, Or Will the Dreamer Wake? Unit 6, Part B, Or Will the Dreamer Wake? Vocabulary Part. Plaintive, adjective, sad. Snuffle, verb, to breathe noisily. Gleaming, adjective, shining softly. Once again, I repeat the words. Plaintive, adjective, sad. Snuffle, verb, to breathe noisily. Gleaming, adjective, shining softly. Glacier, noun, a large mass of ice which usually moves slowly down a mountain. Warbles, verb, to sing with a high continuous but quickly changing sound. I repeat the words. Glacier, noun, a large mass of ice which usually moves slowly down a mountain. Warbles, verb, to sing with a high continuous but quickly changing sound. Birthing pills, noun, the process of giving birth to a baby. Solemn, adjective, very serious and not happy. Crashing, verb, strike with a banging or smashing noise. I repeat the words. Birthing pills, noun, the process of giving birth to a baby. Solemn, adjective, very serious and not happy. Crashing, verb, strike with a banging or smashing noise. Let us see comprehension questions of the poem. Why does the poet say that these cubs could be the last ones ever to freely live and to roam unmate? Why does the thrush weave her nest? What do you think the poem is about? The child could sing the final whale song, says the poet. Why does she say so? The poet says, this could be our last true moment. Is it true? In what way it is true? She waits for all the life she is making. What does the poet convey through this line? What does the grandchild in this poem symbolize? Who is the dreamer here? Who is being referred to? Thank you.